Good morning, viewers. You are welcome to today's devotion with the Daily Fountain, the devotional guide of the Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion. Our topic for today's meditation is humbled to be exalted. Before we proceed, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks, we give you praise for bringing us to the last Saturday of the month of November. We give you thanks because you are our faithful God. Lord, we gather together this morning to listen to your word as we embark on today's journey. We pray that you speak your word to us. Let your word guide us, let your word lead us aright. We pray that all that we shall do today shall bring glory to you and blessings to us. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. People of God, I want to emphasize our topic again. The topic is humbled to be exalted. And our text is taken from Philippians chapter 2. We read from verse 5. Philippians chapter 2, I read from verse 5. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who, being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, taking the form of a bond servant, and coming in the likeness of men, and being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even the death of the cross. Therefore, God also has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of those in heaven and of those on earth and of those under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The Lord bless the reading of his word in Jesus' name. This particular passage is a familiar one that we know, that we can even read it at the tips of our fingers. In Christendom, this passage is not strange. This passage is one of the passages that we often recite, especially we can read from verse 11 to 11 without even missing a word. It's a passage that talks about the humility of Jesus Christ. And our point of emphasis this morning is humility, and that if you humble yourself, God we exhort you. And I pray that as we look at the word of God together this morning, may the Lord clothe us with the garment of humility. May the Lord exhort you as you humble yourself. Because one key thing that kills people today is pride. So many mighty men are falling courtesy of their pride. Many people are falling away from the path of righteousness because of their pride. And this morning, as you look at what God expects from us as Christians, as children of God, the type of attitude that we should clothe ourselves with, which is humility. May the Lord speak his word to us in Jesus' name. And looking through the passage that we read, as we did say, this passage is one of the most challenging in the entire scripture, because it is a part that God, Jesus Christ, being God, did not look at himself as something to be desired. Equating himself with God, he did not desire to put himself side by side with God. Even though, if I may ask, that is Jesus God? The answer is yes. Is God Jesus? The answer is yes. But did Jesus take the position of God? The answer is no. Even though Jesus and God, they are inseparable, they are co-eternal, they are the same, but Jesus has laid a good example for us, a good example that you and I should necessarily follow, if we will be exalted. Jesus Christ did not toe the path of pride of arrogance. And I know today many of us are where we are because we want to belong. We want to get name for ourselves. We want people to be bowing down for us. We want people to be running after scatter, to be paying homage to us. And because of that, we lose sight of our God. Jesus Christ, we are told that even though he is God, but he did not consider it robbery to equate himself with God, but he humbled himself even unto the point of death. Even at the point of death, Jesus humbled himself. Those who were hurling insults at him, those who were killing him, those who were naming him, those who castigated him, those who lied against Jesus, he humbled himself, and what he did was to pray for them. That is a high point of humility. I doubt if we can still get people in our time today, even in the church, who can pray for their enemies. But Jesus did. He prayed for his enemies. He asked God not to count what they did to him as sin against them, but rather he sought God's face for their forgiveness. This is a high point of humility. But generally today, we are all very protective of our reputation, and we do all in our power to protect it, whether it is threatened. Many of us today, we are only interested in what we have, in our name, in what we have acquired, in what we think we have gotten, in what in the wealth we think we have acquired. And many of us, we have acquired all these things not knowing that they have no eternal value. And we place our entire life, we place our strength, we place all that we have on these things that have no eternal consequence. But Jesus forgot everything about the world. Jesus laid down his life. Jesus emptied himself. Jesus did not put all these things, you know, at heart, but he made sure that his focus was on God. He focused on heaven. He looked at everything in this world as ephemeral, and because of that, Jesus forgot all. He was looking for that glorious place where he was going to. And many of us today, because of our achievement, so to say, because of our fame, because of what we have acquired over the years, we become arrogant. We become so proud, and we don't see other creatures as being created by God. We start describing ourselves in the superlative. If somebody talks to you, you will harass the person. I will sue you. Don't you know who you are talking to? Don't you know me? Don't you know me? Don't you know my position? Don't you know my place in this place? But brothers and sisters, let me ask you, who are you? You are just a mere dust. And we are told you are a dust, and unto dust you shall return. Therefore, whatever you think you are, whatever height you think you have attained, one day you will go back to the dust. Because whatever you think you are, if you like have certificates in 30 renowned universities in the whole world, if I feel like you can acquire 40 PhD, people know that you have acquired the knowledge. People know that you have acquired the wealth. But let me tell you, everything will end up in the grave one day. Therefore, whatever opportunity God has given unto you to acquire these, know that you are enjoying the grace of God. People of God, it is by God's grace that you have acquired all this. It is by God's grace that you have gotten all these things. You think is all about your achievement. Therefore, whatever God has allowed you to achieve, know that it is the grace of God that has saved you. And therefore, in turn, you must humble yourself. You must not be like Nebuchadnezzar, who declared, "Is it not this city that I've built by my strength? Is it not this city that I built with my power, with my money, with my resources?" I want you to note the word of God in James chapter 1 verse 17. The Bible tells us that every good and perfect gift comes from above. Therefore, whatever thing you have acquired, always remember that it is God who has given you strength. And therefore, you must humble yourself. Humble yourself so that God we exhort you, do not be like that old fool in the Bible. The man who has seen himself as the person who has made it all. The man who saw himself as the person who was above everybody. He said, what I will do now, I will tear down my barn and build a bigger one. And I will tell my soul, my body, my spirit, take this school. You know, if you have money, you would like to command people around you. If God has given you money, you would like to command to walk majestically as if you are the owner of the land. And this man said, I will tell myself, take this school. You don't need to struggle to go to work early again. You don't need to go to work as early as 5 o'clock. You can just go show your face and come back because you are the general manager. You are the one in charge of your wealth. But God told him that very day, you fool. It was God that called this rich man fool. People of God, you are listening to me this morning. I don't know what God will call you. I don't know what God has even called you. But I want to tell you this morning, if you humble yourself, good for you. But if you are describing yourself in the superlative, if you see your achievements as a result of your power, as a result of your academic attainment, I doubt if God will not call you fool. This man saw himself more than what he was, and God told him, you fool. And that particular day, his life was required from him. And I pray that Lord will grant unto you heart of humility, a heart that will do the will of God, a heart that will fear God, a heart that will obey God. That is my prayer for you this morning. And so shall it be in Jesus' name. However, Jesus, who was sinless and perfect and therefore had a reputation to protect, deliberately made himself of no reputation. Jesus, who had everything at his beck and call, Jesus who can command sun to stand still and the sun will stand still. Jesus who can command his enemy, who can call fire to burn his enemy, and he refused to do so. Jesus who had all the power, he did not consider himself as anything. But he humbled himself in obedience to the word of God. People of God, may I remind you that those things you think you have acquired, those mansions you think you have acquired, those money you have put in soccer ways, those money you have taken abroad, those money you have packed for your generations yet unborn, all have been marked heirs, ready for demolition. One day there shall be an end to all these things. Jesus, who is the owner of the whole universe, did not consider himself as anything, but he humbled himself. He deliberately made himself of no reputation. But can people see you today and see that humility in your life? Even before you are invited to come up for an occasion, you will have displayed all your wealth. You will have told people about yourself. You will have told them that you have several titles at the same time. And anybody that dares omit any of the titles is in trouble. People of God, all these things are not necessary. Humble yourself so that God will exalt you. I pray for you this morning, may the Lord minister to you. May the Lord grant you the grace to humble yourself. Because humility is in response to the induction of our Lord Jesus Christ. And that's exactly what Jesus did. In response to his obedience, humility and sacrifice. Because of that, God was moved. And God now exalted him and gave him a name to which everything in heaven, everything on earth, and below the earth bows, and will continue to bow, and they will continue to bow, and they will bow to eternity, because Jesus humbled himself. He gave him a name that when you hear that name, you tremble. And the Bible says, at the name of this Jesus, every knee bows. That at the name of this Jesus, the righteous run into the name, and they are saved. Courtesy of the humility of Jesus. And because of that, God exalted him. And we are told in the scriptures that this name is a wonderful name. That is the name Jesus. People of God, the only solution to our problems today is the name Jesus that we are talking about. And we call that name by the humility of the Son of God. By the humility of the Son of God. And if you are humble, certain things must be seen in your life. There are certain features that must be practically seen in your life. You don't need to disguise. You don't need to say it. You don't need to demonstrate it. But naturally, it must be seen in your life. If you are humble as a leader, you must respect other people's opinion. You must respect their opinion. Don't see yourself as better than others. Don't see yourself as richer than others. Don't see yourself in the superlative. I don't know the leadership position you have occupied, but I want you to know that you are there by the grace of God. And if you fail to humble yourself, God can dethrone you. Because it is the same God that enthrones. And the same God has power to dethrone. It is the same God that put Nebuchadnezzar. It is the same God that dethroned Nebuchadnezzar. It is the same God that put Saul as a king. It is the same God that dethroned Saul as a king. Because Saul failed to obey God. Saul failed to humble himself and obey the word of God. The same God that enthrones has power at his beck and call to the throne. Therefore, as a leader, do you see yourself as better than others, or you see yourself as being there by the grace of God? Therefore, if you are humble, you must see yourself as a leader by the grace of God, and you must listen to your people. Respect their opinion as well. And the Lord will give you the grace in Jesus' name. What of husband and wife? A husband, God has made you the head of your family. God has made your wife the neck, the supporter, the one that will support you to run this family. But the husband must necessarily see himself as a man who is enjoying the grace of God. According to God's principle, you are not superior to your wife. Neither is your wife inferior to you. You are partners in progress. Therefore, you must humble yourself. You must not see your wife as a trash. You must not, because of your strength, and start beating your wife anyhow. Your wife cannot talk to you anyhow. Your wife cannot even say anything. Before you know it, you are angry. And the next thing is to start beating your wife. Any man that beats his wife is nothing but an animal. If you think you are because of your strength and the wife that God has given unto you, you turn her to a punching bag. I'm sorry to infer this money. Such a man is an animal. But God is talking to you this morning. Even if you have been doing that, you can still humble yourself. Let the grace of God be sufficient for you. Therefore, husband and wife, see yourself. Humble yourself before God. If you humble yourself, your family will move forward. If you humble yourself, your home will move forward. And I pray for you this morning, the spirit of humility, may it come upon you. May the grace of the Lord be sufficient for you. And that is my prayer for you. And it is well with you in Jesus' name. Please, this morning, as you go about our walk, as you go about our schedules, I want to remind you once again, whatever position you have occupied, one thing that God demands from you this morning is humility. One thing that God is asking you to do and practice today is humility. Clothe yourself with the garment of humility, and the Lord will exalt you. May the power of the Lord exalt you. May the grace of the Lord be there for you. May the spirit of humility, may the spirit of obedience, may the spirit that we know necessarily to humble and obey God come upon you. And that is my prayer for you today in Jesus' name. Therefore, this passage teaches us that the only way up is down. In other words, it takes two to tango. If you want God to exalt you, you must humble yourself. Humble yourself before God, humble yourself before man. Do not be like that tax collector and that Pharisee. The Pharisee man says, I'm not like that tax collector. He saw himself more highly, more righteous than others. He said, I'm not like that. I pray 5 times in a day. I fast every day. I do my charitable of sacrifice. I do everything to please God. But I'm not like that man. Is that how you see yourself? Do you see yourself as better than others? For we are told that the tax collectors went home blessed because he humbled himself. And the Pharisee went home disgraced because of pride. Pride goes before a fall. I challenge you this morning. Please clothe yourself with the garment of humility. And the only person that can help you is Jesus Christ. The only man that can help you, that can clothe you with this garment of humility is Jesus Christ. Therefore, if you have Jesus, you will have humility. Why our land is so full of chaos, why we are not able to tolerate one another, is because we don't have this humility. And Jesus Christ is not there in our lives. But I want to challenge you this morning. Give him a trial. Give Jesus a trial in your life, and your life will be different. Therefore, if we empty and humble ourselves before God, he will exalt us. The Lord will exalt you. The Lord will exalt you. But the condition is that you must humble yourself. Jesus proved it. And so, can we, if we determine like him, to completely obey God in every area of our lives without counting the cost? Obey God. Obey God. When people were shouting to Herod, this is not the voice of man, but the voice of God. And Herod was so happy, he was so elated. He was carrying himself more than necessary. And we are told God that God disgraced him. People of God, if you are still carrying yourself around, no matter what you are, your doom is near. Your disgrace is at hand. Therefore, I want to challenge us this morning, within this little time that we have, clothe yourself with the garment of humility. Let the power of the Lord come to your life. Let the spirit of humility rest upon you. And as you go this morning, may the Lord favor you. May the Lord help you. May his grace be sufficient for you. May the joy that humility brings be evident in your life. And that is my prayer for you. It is well with you in Jesus' name. But people of God, the only way out is to give your life to Jesus Christ. Allow him to rule your life. Allow him to guide you. Allow him to lead you in the way of righteousness. Allow him to direct your path. Because a call to humility is an invitation to the way of righteousness. It's an invitation to the way of God's kingdom. And I pray the Lord will guide you aright. May the Spirit of the Almighty God lead you. May the favor of the Lord rest upon you. May the joy of the Lord be your strength. And as you go about your business today, may the presence of the Lord go with you. May the Lord fight all your battles and grant unto you victory. I pray for you today, you will not shed tears. Today, you will not lose your loved ones. Today, may the joy of the Lord rest upon you. I pray any attack of the enemies that is meant for you today shall miss its target in Jesus' name. May the Lord favor you. May the Lord go with you. May today be a day of testimony in your life. May today be a day of joy in your family. May the glory of the Lord cover you. May the Lord give you a heart of humility. May the Lord give you a heart of obedience, just like Jesus demonstrated. And I pray for you that you will be a shining light. People around you will know that of a truth, you serve a living God. And you'll be a signature of all eyes for good. This is my prayer for you. It is well with you, and so shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. People of God, we want to thank you for fellowship with us this morning. And we pray that the Lord will continue to bless us. Therefore, we invite you to join us tomorrow morning, same time, same station, for another special edition of the Daily Fountain. And if you are led to sponsor or support this program, please contact the numbers and email or showing on your screen. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/ACNN TV. You can also check out our website at www.acnntv.com. Thank you and God bless.